What is up, guys? And of course, welcome to episode 5 of course, my Nuzlock, and the sun is in my eyes. Doesn't hurt at all. No. Alright, that should do it. But yeah, as you saw in previous episode, we actually made it to the Glittering Cave. And we have a Drift Limb, which is actually level 15 now, and it has a Gust. That's about it, actually. And we are in this area to catch our next Pokemon, both as fossil and, of course, as, well, random encounter here. Let's see, I think I should make it back. There are a few items here which are worth getting. I do believe we have that TM in this area. Or, you know, nothing. But you can face a Kangaskhan here, which is definitely ideal. While I'm saying that, I do realize that if I face a Kangaskhan, then I am in trouble. Kangaskhan is extremely powerful. This early in the game, it's definitely powerful. Let's see, which one do we get? Cubone! That's okay. I'm not terribly mad. Cubone is actually kind of cool. Alright, I'll easily take a female Cubone. Bone Club, how about no? No! Not on me, sucker. Tailor Whip, alright, I can deal with that. So, don't die? Yeah! How about no? We got a freaking Cubone of all the things! Never use a Cubone in any game, ever. So we're gonna name this one XENON, even though it's a female. XENON had long hair once. Totally legit. Oh dear god, just don't do it. What, you had headbutt? Well, I'm immune because I'm flying! No, because I'm a ghost, but the Bone Club, I'm immune to reduce my flying. It's so cool. Like, Marowak is actually quite viable. Due to its move pool is actually really, really good, even though the stats is not so cool. But we should definitely do well here. I am all for this. If you're wondering what I'm doing, I'm kind of hearing strange sounds from the somewhere around here. But I do believe my refrigerator, is that the right word, is just getting old. Should probably replace that. Just, they're so expensive. Not that money is a big issue. Alright, so the next Pokemon here is Machop. Alright. That's okay, though. You are very unlikely to have a dock move on you. Oh, look at that. Is that a crit? No. The only thing I should fear from this guy is Foresight combination. Like, if it starts up with Foresight, I might be in trouble. But I say might. Because I think I can take it on anyway. I think. Oh, Pokeball! And it's a hard stone. One has to wonder... if you find a stone, and it's obviously... it's supposed to be hard from the beginning. So how do you distinguish that this stone is clearly harder than somebody else's stone? Like, honestly, I actually want to know. Like, somebody grabbed the stone bar. This is a hard stone. Yeah, this is a hard stone. Like, nah, I don't buy it. Alright, level 17. That could be troublesome. Oh, I didn't go for the Foresight, though. That's good. Obviously, that crit helped. I'm not sure that would have been a two-hit KO. Because it's still Gust, of all the things. It's still freaking Gust. I really hope to get a TM here, and something useful. That's a Solrock, though. Now, that would have been cool also to get. What do I do against a Solrock? Guess I'm gonna bring Canapus here. Because Solrock can I don't think it carries psychic or something. It gets confusion, of course. That did do damage. That did do damage. Alright, I'm gonna go for lead seed here. Because even if I can't fend it off... It's a side wave. Ugh. Really? Really? That does hurt. It does hurt a whole lot, actually. Gonna go to Frogadier here. That did way more than I was hoping for, or was aiming for, or whatever. Rock Polish. Alright, so speed is now an issue, too. Well, I guess we'll just have to deal with it. Hang on tight! Come on, Psywave, don't do any strange damage to me. That works. This should kill you. Nope, the lead seed is helpful here. It's obviously helpful. Solrock is a bit OP this early in the game. It's not as OP as Kangaskhan, but it sure as hell pushed me back. And gave a lot of XP air. Smokescreen, no thank you. Serenade level 16. Learn something decent. Payback is not decent. Though better than Astonish. Definitely better than Astonish. Payback means that I go late. Which might actually be kind of stupid. Okay. And there's supposed to be an HM there. Or it looked like it was an HM there. Just gonna give a potion to Ivysaur, because that is a mon I definitely don't want. Weakened Shadow Claw. Oh, I guess Furret got a lot better now. Yeah, and only Furret, sadly. Scout Donut is getting there. Alright, I guess I'll take that over Furret Swipes. So now I can. Now I'm not. Like, if I meet a ghost type Pokemon, I'm not completely screwed against it. And I mean, the big thing about Furret is that it actually gets Surf. Like, it's probably one of the few mods I feel comfortable with that in mind. So, yeah, not too shabby. I was expecting Dig, but this is way better. Scout Donut. Alright, what are we gonna fend off against this time? More Machops, please. I guess another Solrock would actually have been awesome. Since they gave so much XP, that is. Not that I necessarily can hurt them. But this guy is completely walled by me. I mean, even ground types are pretty much screwed versus this guy, so it's... It's a very real situation for a few of these Pokemon, so I'm definitely looking forward to hopefully use my Drifloom here in the future. I don't have Rock Smash, can I realize that? That's kind of bad, isn't it? Alright. Yeah, bring it on, sucker. Yeah, I like to play with fire. Oh yeah, that was probably the other way around. Houndour. Nay. That's overdoing it, buddy. That is overdoing it. This is a situation I definitely feel screwed against. So... Frogadier it is. At least I can take on one of its stabs. Nay. Don't be so eager, Serenade. Your time will come soon enough. Smog. Okay. Lower accuracy? No. Possible poison. Yeah, that's about it. I do believe Water Pulse is close to actually one hit KOing it. That works for me. Serenity level 17. Still crap. Ah, Zubat! finally. I've been waiting for something like this. I haven't seen that Zuba the whole game. Unexpectedly happy about seeing a Zubat. There we go. Alright, Grunt. Time's up. But here's the thing, though. I am not sure what I will be facing. Having that in mind. Let's see. Can I grab a potion here? Because since Frogadier is somewhat fragile, even if it has healthy HP, it's still in, you know, the rough spot. So if I have to switch that in, then I really need it to come in with somewhat health, or being somewhat healthy. Gulpin. Gulpin is cool, though. Gulpin is really cool. Rain on, sucker. Haha, avoid attack. I was supposed to be the fat one, not you. I mean, payback will do nothing. I was supposed to kill you. Alright, Scout Donut, you're up. Sludge. That is so far from ideal. That is so far from ideal. Cannabis, you're up. You know, when Gulpin is a threat, then you know you're doing something wrong. I swear. No, not liquid ooze too. Okay. I'm gonna go for sleep powder. Oh my god. This Gulpin though, this Gulpin. How much damage do I lose? That's more than enough, and of course, you know, I am asleep too here. I don't even know what to say. And he woke up, of course. I'm getting screwed over. Alright, so I have to use a super potion then. This is the worst battle ever. This Gulpin just ends me. And I'm falling out of my chair. There we go. Alright, so at least I am in full health now, which hopefully will be important. But it's dead! It's some kind of aftermath here. Come on, baby! Don't do this to me. Ah, Race Belief, that's definitely better than Wine Whip. Oh, the liquid ooze on this guy. Alright, Scout Donut, level up. Electric. And you can't do anything to me. But I am asleep. Hopefully I'll wake up soon enough. Show me howl! I think that's about it. Even so, I don't think... I mean, as long as I keep myself asleep, who knows, right? Keeps howling. There we go. Using Lair on me? No, until it's attacking, I don't know how strong it really is. But I do believe Venoshock should do decent damage on it. Or outright kills it. Yeah. Gulpin. I'll probably never look at a Gulpin the same way again. Let's see. Antidotes. There we go. And Super Potion on Furret. That Gulpin. I mean, wow. I don't think I can say anything more than that. Oh, is this a doubles battle? No. Oh, kinda. Yes, let's team up. You have a decent Pokemon and I can attack. Because you're gonna start with Fletchling or... Fletchinder, I mean. Scamhinder, whatever. One money each. Scraggy and Crocogunk. That could be terrifying. Esperler, why? They're physical attackers. Why would you go for light screen? Faint at... Oh, crap. Oh, but she has an Absol! That's not gonna help! Oh, shit. Ugh. I have to bring cannabis. Faint attack just ruins everything for me. Taunt. Okay. So now it has to attack. Faint attack. Now that's better. Purple Rocky Helmet. Ouch. Purple Rocky Helmet. So I can't take two of those, which is just splendid. So I'm banking on this Absol to solving something for someone of us. I really need this Absol to attack. That's a freaking quick attack, buddy. They're annihilating me, and you're gonna go for a quick attack. Brick break. Oh, and that's Absol gone. No! Oh my god, I swear, the game is over. My game is over. I'm gonna go for a sleep powder on that Scrappy. Oh, come on, Quilladin! Out of nowhere! These battles! Oh, thank god. Oh, a second later. There's a Venoshock on that guy. Goes for Bite. It's hell of a resistant, though. Oh, please kill. That's gonna be extremely helpful. Oh, you were flinched. Yes. And roll out. That's kind of unimpressive, Krillin. Obviously, the superior Grass Star has to solve this. How about that? But yeah, that turned kind of ugly, actually. You know, when you see Moxie kicks in, you know, life gets kind of real for a few seconds. It gets kind of real. Oh, but you're not going to heal my Pokemon. Thank you for nothing. And I actually need this guy's healthy. The issue with Drifblim is that it has so much HP that, you know, one really assumed that, you know, it's gonna work, but it's so clear that it isn't, and I missed out on that item, so that's really bad. Did you find him? No. There's a fossil as well. I want your fossil. Yes. ORAS is just not that good. Oh wait, you're not gonna... Okay, yeah. I was one... No? We're stuck here. You're kidding, right? I have to go all the way back? Okay, thanks. Now, one has to wonder, how far are you prepared to send me? I swear I'm just gonna get out, you know, straight out the cave, that's about it, yeah. Why? Heal me. So I used those potions in vain, obviously, but I feel fine with that. I'm trying to, you know, which Mon do I really want to use? Do I want to use Tyrant, or there is the Helioptile I was looking for? Why are you so late? I'd rather have you over Hippopotas. But yeah, do I want to use Marowak, or do I want to use Tyrantrum, or Tyrant? Issue with Tyrant is it has a late evolution. A late evolution often means that it'll definitely fall... Well, before anything good happens. Also, Crocodile. Crocodile is kind of good. Too bad it doesn't get you either. Pretty sure you can a Dark Move, so I'm not going to even risk it on you. Oh, that was the wrong way. We're not there yet. Oh, you're kidding, right? I like the, at least the concept of riding Pokemon actually debuting Generation 6. Like, they wanted to test something with this. And, obviously, they only got it to work this slow. So I'm kinda glad that that took an extra step forward in Next Generation game. We'll see what happens with Tyrant, but in worst case, I'm actually going to give up on Pikachu, I think. Or the P-Shocker, because I get a Thunderstone. I actually get a Thunderstone a bit later, but the issue with that is, of course, that Pikachu actually is at risk of dying. So wait, I didn't get to nickname it? They just send it in there? Oh, look! It has Thick Club! Alright, that settles it. Get the fuck out, Pikachu. I got a freaking Thick Club. There's a 5% chance of that happening. And it's serious. Yeah, I'll say. I'm never letting you go, female Xenon. Now, is it as they say? Is it really? Do I remember so wrong? I must do. I was so sure NFDs were giving me a TM. No, I give him an Aerodactylite. Yeah, and I still haven't got Rock Smash. I'm pretty sure either I get it from someone around here, or I've just missed that out. Let's see, do you want to trade a Pokeball for my Dieball? Yeah, absolutely. Idiot. there it is. Alright, but it's not like I really can use that anyway to get another Pokemon that is. But a lot of Pokemon killed in Rock Smash. Among them is actually female Xenon. I'm gonna call it female Xenon for a bit too long, I guess. Little Tail Whip, what do I lose? That works. I don't think Furret necessarily needs it with Shadow Claw in mind. So, yeah, that works. Should save, actually. Not because I, you know, need it or anything, but you know, we've better cut to stuff like that. That would be extremely unfortunate. Alright, and I can just skip this area. He gives me an old rod for catching a Magikarp. Gonna feel like I don't need that. New route means new Pokemons. And I have two options. Either I get that old rod and catch a Magikarp, or I embrace life. Which usually means, I have no idea where I'm gonna get this with this. Let's see, a pearl. Nice. Yeah, but this area you can kind of save for either if you get Surf or if there is some grass in this area, which I assume is not. Actually, you can meet them all through Rock Smash here. We're gonna revive. Which I can't use. I kind of forgot about that. Could face a Geodude. Or, you know, anything we'll do here. Just want to catch another Mon. There we go. We're gonna phase. A Dwebble. And, how much does a Bone Club do? Oh, accuracy fell. That's not good. Rock Smash might be better. Faint attack. That's not gonna work on me. Foul Fiend. No, the sand is annoying me. Alright, withdraw is good. Withdraw is really good. In case Rock Smash kills, that's actually far from it. Guess we're doing Bone Club anyway. Oh, no more sand attack. What's the matter with you? Alright, one more time. I obviously have to switch Pokemon because this is gonna get... Yeah. Accuracy is a bitch. It was Faint Attack it used, so I'm guessing we're going to Canapiss actually. Because it doesn't wall it, but it doesn't do so much damage on it. Because Venoshock is resisted, which means that I will do damage, but hopefully not too much. No Dwebble. It was his fault though. Had he not used freaking Sand Attack on me, he might actually have survived. Which is really his fault. And now I'm out of Dwebble. I actually wanted Dwebble. Dwebble. Oh. I'm actually a bit disappointed. Alright, so... Or actually, that was for... Ah, that's good. That was in that city. So I can still catch a Pokemon this route. I guess that's... Take a bit of the good with the bad then. Good with the bad. Berry. Mago Berry.
Mago! Hey, Mago!
Let's see. You can find treasure. Yeah, or I don't care about that. One bit. Yeah, how about you let me go? Well, yeah, anybody remember the big deal? People were kind of acting up when they first saw the screenshot of these people and that they were in bikinis. You know, obviously we'd never seen that before. We're seeing people in bikini before. What I'm trying to say is we never had a big screenshot about it, therefore it was a big deal. Wingull is not nice to me, so we're just gonna get out. I really don't have any proper switch into this guy, though. Get Scout Donut is as good as it gets.
Scout Donut!
Water pools, yeah, it's splendid. At least I'm faster. Ooh, sweet. Ah! The donut guy! Can't take this. Damn you, Wingull. And I swear, it doesn't really give any XP either. Psyduck. I don't want to deal with you. So, Ivysaur it is, and don't for the crying of God have confusion here. See, Water Pulse is fine. That's resisted. Even though confusion is a thing. But I do really raise leaves to it KO at least. Yeah, it works. And doesn't show confusion. That's good. That's good. And doesn't confuse me. That's also good. 20% chance is more than enough. I think it's even 30 now that I think about it. So we don't want that. Yay! Canapist level 21. Getting dangerous by the second. Okay. There is an issue using, of course, Cubone first, and that is that it's very likely that I'll only face water Pokemon in this area. Or very likely. It's kind of implied that that's going to be the thing. So I'm trying to avoid actually a few trainers here. I think that's the right thing to do. As we're going to see Masquerine! And that thing has Intimidate. Level 22 Masquerine. Won't lie, that's kind of overdoing it. Scout Donut or Chicklian? Thing is, I'm pretty sure the reason it's here is because it has Water Pulse. Haven't met a Masquerade, so I'm not completely sure. Let's find out. Bubble. Ouch. Okay, but I'm kind of expecting something bigger to come this way. Quick attack is not bigger. But damn! Okay, that was a crit. That was like, what? Masquerade has no attack? Yeah. I'll see what is going. As long as I don't see Bugbuzz. Or Sillerwind or whatever. Hurt yourself. Thank you. That works for me. Do I kill it now? Yay! Piss off, Masquerine. I'm alive! Even XENON is alive. Focus energy. Actually, I'll take that over. What's that, Tail Whip? Alright! It's a big deal of defeating these kind of, I was gonna say monsters, but not really monsters. But definitely needed something there. I mean, Masquerade is maybe not the most intimidating mon, but it packs a punch, for sure. So right, now we're in the new city, and here is where the rock gym is. Which is good. I intend to clear that gym. Hello, sir. Satchet. Oh yeah, to evolve Aromatisse. Or two aromatis. I can't remember what that mon is called. I'll think about it. Yay, ether. Here is where the foundation of ether was starting. Always good to talk with everybody else. Just in case I get something good. Now the thing is here, we are actually in a situation where I kinda need to progress somewhat, because as of right now, Cubone is not made to deal with the gym that is here. See, would you like me to massage your Cubone? Nah, get your filthy hands away from me. Stay away, human. Might as well go to the focus center and heal myself up and actually grab a few items. Bum bum ba bum. Hello. More super potion, that was about it, alright. That works. Because you can get the bicycle here. Yeah, precisely. Now the question is, do you get it after the gym, or you can get it right now? Let's find out. So he was like, you're the 1,000th customer, therefore you get it for free. It kind of feels like, you know, every kind of, what do you call it, like those, you know, you're the 1,000th that came to this area, therefore you get $1,000 basically. Enter your credit card here. But we actually got something from it. Okay. So what I need to do now is, like I said, go into that new area which is here. Not only can we catch a new Pokemon, which is awesome, but... Oh, that is that guy who says my power level is over 9,000, if I remember correctly. He got kind of famous. Psychic Robert uses Solisis. Is that the evolved form? No, it's not. Maybe, just maybe, I can not be one to kill by this. Snatch. Okay. Wow. That means Bone Club probably KO it. Boom! Right in a kisser! Right in a kisser. And that gave nothing! I got no XP! I got no XP, and I didn't show you, but it says something with 9,000. Okay, so which Pokemon are we facing here? Snabble! It's a Snabble! It's female Snabble, that's... And why? It didn't have Intimidate. That is not good. That is not good. Oh, look at that. He bite me. So that's obviously not a Howlucha. I guess if I'm gonna catch this one, then I'll probably have to switch Pokemon. Sorry, female XENON. Ugh. You can do this, Canopus! Hurt by Rocky Helmet. Oh no! No, 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 no! Well, that was unfortunate. Wait, you don't want to battle? Female, thank you. Alright, so we don't get that. That's very, very boring. Skip loon. Huh. You can hurt me. But I'm not sure you can hurt Serenade. I swear, that is the most annoying move in the game. I swear. Oh, I don't like that move at all. Now, I don't believe Skiploon can do anything to me. I got Fury Wind. That is actually neutral damage, so good for you. The only issue I have is that I can't know... Oh, it actually outspeeds me. I was gonna say, I can't really do too much to it either, outside of Gust. You are a terrible Pokemon, and I don't like you. I'm kinda glad Fairwind isn't hurting me that much, because I'm not gonna go for another... what do you call, awakening here, since it's very obvious that his AI has decided that I should be asleep. Oh, come on, Grifflim, you really need to step out of this. Come on, buddy. Come on, buddy. Buddy, yes. You are going to have hell versus me. I am not backing down now. Finally. Finally. Going down, buddy. Oh, that's actually quite... How did that land? I am plus 6 evasion. And I'm fully... Fuck this game so hard. Oh. This is just the worst day ever. Go to Fairwind. Oh, avoided the attack. I really hope you only have Skiploom, because I want to kill a lot of Skiploom right now. Just having you know that. XENON level up, sweet. Next mon, dance pass. Hey buddy. You guys gonna go for focus energy too? See that? I'm getting pumped as fork. Gonna get for those critical hits with Gust. Oh yeah, oh yeah. Feel my power, dance boss. Feel it. I'm doing nothing to it. That was a crit too. Did I get a second? No. What is this? Why do they want to get me asleep so bad? And why do it always land? That's right, it has access to Pursuit, but actually will do super effective damage on me. Question is how much super effective damage that is. It's still a dance pass, which means that it's hardly that strong if he were to land it on me. I shouldn't be this long asleep. Drifloon is like a small thing right now. Alright, now it got Screech on me, so therefore I'm gonna go for a super potion in case he lands something on me. Because due to him having Pursuit, I can't switch out my Pokemon either. Alright, Ancient Power. So that's the last move. So Pursuit is his only move that actually will distinguishably hurt me. And that should be Dance Boss dead. Nice. Yay, level 19. Can we learn a real move? We cannot. Sumeril? Okay. That's kind of bad, actually. Defense Krill. Assumeril is one step beyond what I'm expecting. You can curl all you want, I just don't want you to have huge power and actually hit me. We're gonna score those crit. There is a... And he lands the rollout! Oh! Holy fucking shit. He won't be able to land two of those. That's impossible. That's impossible. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Serenade, serenade, serenade. Don't... Yes. Holy fucking shit. Oh, it's so close. Alright, went for defense curl. Great. So we get to kill this guy, which is definitely like all I wanted. Damn, Azumarill this early. Doesn't matter what level, it's still an imminent threat. Ominous Wind, yes, finally a decent attack from you. Or on you, from you, I don't know. That was actually kind of scary. All right, let's see which one we face here. I'm going to go against my rule a little bit, since I killed this Snabble by mistake. I kind of feel that I have to redeem myself somewhat, so I'm actually going to catch this guy. And I know it sounds like a pretty bad cop-out, and it probably is, but I really, really, really wanted to catch a Pokemon here, and I totally forgot about about the Rocky Helmet. Now the bigger question is whether or not I actually can win against this thing. Probably isn't the right mod to kind of try to solve this. How much does a wing attack do? Well, that's up there. That's up there. Air Lace, isn't that the same move? Ooh, wow. Okay. Kind of feel that if somebody would say, you know, if I had some kind of voice for, you know, what the hit would mean, someone would, like, scream after that peck hit, like, underwhelming! Nothing more. Just define my situation. It has a roost! Oh, you are not helping, buddy. You are not helping. You're so begging to get Flame Body on you. I kind of need that to happen. Because I can't do anything against this guy. I can't survive him, though, which is kind of nice. Still no Flame Body. Cut out the shop. That's resisted. That's good. No. We're gonna use Peck. Wing attack. Right. Take that gamble, Chris. Let's see. Dusk Ball. Easier to catch at night, or yeah, and it's night in my game for some reason, so Dusk Ball it is. Come on, get him! Get him! Yes! Hawlucha! Ooh, that's so cool! Finally something good happened in my life! No, I don't know.
Wow.
What one name, Mahalucha? Could call him Deathstroke. Or Lucha Libre. Lucha Libre it is. And in one word. There we go, Lucha Libre. And this is definitely a mon I'm gonna use. I should say that it wouldn't matter if I met a Halucha there at all, though it's very, very lucky. But it was just a matter of me screwing up that catch against Snabble, so I kind of was aiming to get Snabble there. But this is way better. This is way, way better. This would have been way better. Motherfucking Sigalith. Can we even hurt you? Psywave is gonna do to me what? Alright, that is not a lot of damage. But we aren't really doing that much either. Could try to take another hit there. Because Psywave is not that intimidating of a move. Even though the damage output is somewhat randomized. But we are not gonna win this. Gonna go to Frogger there. Really wish Frogger was a dark type now. Probably one of the few times you guys will hear me say that. Zybeam, that's way worse. Ouch. Okay. Gonna go for Whirlpools here. Does that speed me? Oh, wow, okay. That's not good. Oh, did we kill? We got a crit! Oh. That's, I don't like them one bit, now do I? Yeah, we need to get out of here. We definitely need to get out of here. No more Sigaliths! Oh, and Halucha is not helping, buddy! Halucha is not helping. Doesn't matter if it started to rain, I'm still kind of screwed. Gonna go to Chickling End then. Let's see. Scott Donut was not the mono switched in there. Thing is, doesn't Halucha give a lot of XP? I could try to defeat it because. Ooh, this one has some promising ability. Or not ability itself, but rather it did a lot of damage to me. Karate Shop, that's better, buddy. That's better. Now, please, Flame Body, kick in! There we go. Now everything is under control. Ish. I really wish I had Roost. But yeah, we're not gonna attack him this time because I'm pretty sure that I'll die anyway. If I attack him, that is. So we are gonna do a cop out here and let the burn finish him off. Let's see, Erlaze, how much would I have done? Okay, I would not have died there, but, you know, I'm not risking that. I'm not. And, yeah! The thing is here, I'm actually think I'll give up Fletch Hinder for Halucha. I think that's the right way to go at it, even though I like it. I like Chicklingen, but Halucha is just so much better. And I definitely didn't expect to get Halucha in this playoff. I was really hoping, or not hoping, but I was pretty sure that I would get some of those really, really crappy spawns there. But getting both Sigalith and Halucha in that area, pretty cool actually, because they're not really that common. I'm not banking like getting detonated next area after this. Let's see. Hawlucha is relaxed. Okay, so it's a bad Hawlucha, but it's an Hawlucha. And that's really all I care for. Air Lace is definitely better in wing attack, so that's how we're gonna do it. So a slow Hawlucha. A lazy, fat Hawlucha. And we're calling him Lucha Libre. Actually, thinking about it, it makes sense. A fat Hawlucha probably would be a bit more relaxed about his life. Alright, we are actually going to try to take on that gym anyway, before this episode's end. Episode end. Actually, I have some time to spare. If I just can remember how I got up there. Not this way. Definitely not that way. The only issue I kinda have is that... I know that my Cubone is not made for this battle particularly well. Let's see. La 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 la. Strength. That's cool. That we could give to Furret. Over return. Even though return is the stronger move, I kind of think Furret makes sense to have that move. It's not that much weaker than return, or rather, it'll take some time before return becomes strong enough to be actually superior to strength from this season on. And I guess the bigger issue here is that Furret is not going to be very, very useful for this gym anyway. Man, hoping for that surf. Not that X defense. And the bigger question is here, against the gym leader itself, Cubone is actually really good, but ORAS is still going to be faster, which means that I have to have a better idea versus that than I have right now. So Hawlucha is probably going to be my number one response to him. Hello, talk to me. Alright, you didn't want anything. I'm going to go back. I missed the item there. Saw the item a bit late. It doesn't matter. I have to go down again anyway. Down... Oh, what am I doing? Totally missing out on that item. It's a bit longer episode today, guys. Be glad. Because I sure as hell am. And that was a special attack raid, so that was... I don't know why I say be glad. Like, I'm glad you guys were watching. If you watched this far, then no, thank you for that. But yeah, we're gonna probably kick it in 17 minutes. Because I kind of want to end with the gym battle. And I really hope, because I can't remember which level these rookies were at. Rising Star, gonna use Dwebble. It's gonna use Dwebble against me. And you can't Dwebble around with me. I have no idea what I'm trying to figure out here. But yeah, level 21 is definitely overdoing it. Let's see, Rock Blast, Mist Attack, Bone Club, 50% hit, easy. I lied. Faint Attack, yeah, that's gonna land at least. Burno Krabu! I wish it did more. I really wish it did more. It was a Faint Attack again, so yeah. We'll see if I can take the next matchup better. The only perk with Cubone here is Fit Club. Really can't. No! That's too much, buddy. That is too much. That is too much. Okay. Okay, I see you. Gonna go to Canopus and... Water Gun, yeah? That's okay. That's really okay. This is the kind of worst kind of situations we're gonna have. Though this should wanna kill it. Isn't that four times effective? My god, alright. I'm desperately in need of Giga Rain. Physically defensive, really can't actually pull through here. Wow, did you see that damage? I can take another one of those, but that still did a lot. Okay. Relicant got scary. Relicant got really scary. Alright, I did level up at least, so I'm feeling a bit comfortable here. XENON level up 2, that's good. I really need him to be faster. Somehow. Because if he hurt or lands his damage first, then he's actually really good. And I can't use Ferret, even though it's the lowest level I got, actually. But I can't use Ferret due to... well, let's just say the matchup is very unpromising here. Alright, that was not nice. It's a trap. I'm actually trying to figure out how I should beat ORAS the easiest way. Because I do believe they're both level 25, which is... well, I would lie if I say they weren't OP by any chance here, because they really are. Tyrantrum is not an issue, or not as big of an issue, and Solrock is actually an issue. I can't land hits on you, can I? Shit. Alright. Frog, there it is. And Psywave, how much will you do? Okay, that's actually not too bad. Water Pulse should do 50%? More than enough, at least. So it didn't look like a comfortable 50%, if you ask me. Rock Throw. Like I said, it wasn't a comfortable 50%, so I'm getting my HP back here. Frogadier is not a Pokemon, to say least. Okay. Refocus. Level 22. Right. Stronger, better, all that jazz. XENON level 71, 71, Boomerang. That's a OP move, actually. And it's more accurate. Alright. Lunatune. I'm just gonna keep going. That's all I can do. But this is not gonna be a 50% hit. Oh, sweet mother. Taking a gamble! Taking a gamble! Come on, Frogadier! Don't pull this off, please! Yes! I got a crit there at the end! Oh, we're not screwed! Oh my god, I was dangerous. Oh, dear lord. Ugh. We're not screwed. We're not screwed. Oh, shit. I'm not joking though, against the gym leader itself, I kinda have to use Hawlucha from the start here. I really need to one it KO it. I need to one it KO a freaking ORAS. If I can't do that, then I can't win this gym, basically. And he's gonna use a Rhyhorn. That's good. That's good. I think I can cope with a Rhyhorn. Go, XENON! Now, wait, Boomerang! That is gonna hurt. Oh my god, look at that! Dropping like a fly! As he goes for Rock Tomb. Really? You're gonna lower my speed? I was so glad that I finally was faster than something. Which I should have kept being, actually. Okay. Buddy! There we go. Knocked it out of the park. Nose pass. Okay. I should be able to kill you. Rock throw, resisted hit at least. Boomerang, one hit KO, or down to 30. Nope, not even. Does Fit Club only expect Marowak, or am I really that weak? Guess it's a little bit of both. Onyx. Okay, buddy. Let's do this. You see this? See this? This is the power of the club. But damn, I got no XP from this. I really got nothing. So I believe now is the gym battle. Yeah. Better prep myself. I have two options, actually. I could also just bring Frogadier and water pulse it. No, it's neutral due to its water type being no. Ice is only resistant to ice, so water pulse should do decent damage. Let's do this. This is gonna be a tough game. I am not looking forward to lose any Mon now, and I'm being... Like, I really doesn't hope she starts up with Tyrantrum. I'm pretty sure she doesn't. But I do remember that he or she will... I guess that's a he? Will start or have level 25 Mons. Start with some Amarua. That's good. And like I said, level 25. And my Water Pulse should do decent on it. And I am faster, thank God. Yeah, that is not decent. That is not decent. Oh, that's not gonna help me. That's not gonna help me one bit, buddy. Come on. Yes. And yes. You will die next turn for sure, but... You are gonna use a super potion on you, I'm sure about that. Hyper potion even, alright, so it's back to full. I'm not fully paralyzed yet, which is kinda good. I'm basically doing around 25-30% here. So this is actually helping me a lot. Snaps out of confusion, goes for takedown. Alright. Oh no, that's not good. Takedown did a lot of damage for being a resisted hit. You know, it's with of course refrigerate or whatever it's called. But that, you know, knocks it out of four. Goes for Aurora Beam. That shouldn't hurt too much. Go for a quick attack here, come on. Yes! And please kill it. No! Shit! Alright. Oh, that was a crit. Of course it was. I really need to buy super potions after this. Go for takedown, please. Thank you. So right, now Tyrantrum comes in. Or Tyrant. And the only response I have to that is actually Ivysaur. And we're looking at a situation of late season again, which is quite uneventful, but that's the best I got here. Don't think it gets access to... or I hope it doesn't get access to Dragon Dance this early in the game. I'm kind of banking on that not happening. Lead seed and, you know, sleep powder and basically do damage whenever I can. Stomp. That hurts. I hurt you too, obviously. Lead seed first. We do outspeed it, which is very important. Rock tomb. Alright. How about no? I take every sheep shot I can get here. Therefore, sleep powder. And we do land it or connect it. I mean, that's 75%, so it's always unfortunate when it isn't hitting. This looks good. This looks promising. We're looking to doing way better than I was expecting for this particular game. I was pretty sure I was gonna get ravaged here. But now I feel comfortable. Because Tyrant is not too intimidating. Rock Tomb did so much damage. Okay. That I did not expect it to do so much on me. Gonna go for a super potion here. What the hell just happened? Right, bite. Yeah, with strong jaw that actually does hurt. Did we kill it? Yeah, it's going down! And that's the second badge in the bag. Can one say that? I wonder. But yeah, that's cool. Yeah, the reason I wanted to kind of state about, of course, the obvious is that this is probably the first gym. This is the first gym you face is not too scary. But the second gym is where it starts, like, they don't use too many Pokemon. But it's very clear that they have an extremely high level. And that's why I wanted, I was going to say Xenon, but Cubone to be slightly stronger. But obviously we didn't solve that. But that's alright. That is actually quite alright. You can't get them all. But we got Rock Tomb. And that is a game changer, because there are a lot of mods that can learn this rock move. It's fairly accurate. So both Hawlucha, Cubone, and I do believe Frogadier can learn this move. And it's helpful for all of them. Though immensely much, much more for poor Cubone, who have been walled out so far by every flying Pokemon. So, yeah, I'm gonna give up focus energy there. I kind of want to keep Headbutt. A bit longer, at least. And Frogadier needs it, because it only has Water Pulse as its viable option of attacking, and it's not particularly viable. Other than that, we have Lick. So, Lick is out. I'm basically waiting for Dark Pulse, or any Dark move, really. But yeah, so far the team looks really, really, really solid. Really need to level up Scout Donut here, of course, but I actually like my team. And this is gonna end the session for, of course, this particular video. Of course, episode 5, actually a bit longer than usual, but I really wanted to gym out of the way. Next time you see me is with a different clothing, and we're gonna, of course, keep recording roughly an hour. And then we're gonna actually head off to, do you believe, the next cave with the Wobbuffet and stuff like that. So next episode, bit scarier. A lot scarier, actually. So, thank you so much for watching, as always, guys, really. And I'll see you in the next video. Until then, take care. Bye. Damn this song!